Good morning, students. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on the time that you watch this video. This is Miguel, my friends. And today, we're going to speak about party tips, okay? Party tips, how many and how much, how to talk about quantity. Let's start, okay? To express how much food we have or need, we use certain words called quantifiers. But there are some differences when using countable or uncountable nouns. Let's learn how to express quantity with these words. Large amounts, for example, countable nouns. Okay. Remember, countable nouns are those that have a singular and a plural form. For example, you can say an apple, two apples, a table, two tables, a boy, two boys. Okay. For example, you can say, how many apples are there? Okay, remember, how many, look, is for countable nouns. How many apples are there? How many tomatoes are there? How many onions are there? And the answer is, there are a lot of apples, or there are lots of apples. Uncountables, okay? Uncountables never have a plural form. Okay, for example, rice, oil, grass, hair, beans, okay. For that, or for something like here, meat, okay. For that, you use how much. How much meat is there? Remember, how much rice is there? How much oil do you have? How much water do you drink? And the answer is, there is a lot of or lot of meat, okay. A lot of is used, okay, with countable and uncountable sentences, okay, with countable and uncountable nouns. Why? Because it means much of anything, okay? Remember, a lot of and lots of can be used with countable and with uncountable nouns. Look, for example, smaller amounts, countables, okay? For example, once again, carrots. Carrots is countable. You can say one carrot, two carrots, three carrots, okay? And you can say there are some, a few carrots. Remember, a few is used for countable nouns. Uncountable noun like cheese, you say, how much cheese is there? And the answer can be, there is a little cheese. Remember, some, a few, a little have a positive meaning, okay? Remember, very easy. A few is for countable nouns, and a little is for uncountable nouns, okay? And that is, a few and a little refer to small amounts, okay? To not to have too much or too many of 18. However, to have a little amount of something, okay? Simple, a few is for countable nouns and a little is for uncountable nouns. Look at another example, smaller amounts too. Here you have vegetables, okay? You have carrots. How many carrots are there? You can say there are many carrots. Uncountables, how much cheese is there? There isn't much cheese, okay? Not many, not much have a negative meaning, okay? Remember, many is for countable nouns and much is for uncountable nouns, okay? Many carrots, many tomatoes, many people, many boys. Much cheese, much oil, much grass, much ice cream, okay? Here, smaller amounts number three, countables. Look at this, okay? For example, positive meaning, some or a few, okay? Negative meaning, not many, few, okay? Uncountables, positive meaning, some, a little. Negative meaning, not much, little. Remember, here it depends on the emphasis that you want to express in English, okay? If you want to give a positive meaning, you can use some or a few with countable nouns. But if you want to give a negative meaning with countable nouns, you can use not many or few. The same for uncountable nouns. If you want to express a positive meaning, you can use some or a little. A negative meaning is not much, little, okay? Using the negative meaning expresses that you want to complain about something, okay? That you are not feeling happy about something. Look, single amount, countables. How many hot dogs are there? Remember, countables you can count, okay? There is only one hot dog, okay? For uncountables, how much milk is there? Okay. Why? Because milk is uncountable. There is, remember, with uncountable nouns, you can say there is one milk. No. For that, this is an, one or two can be used with uncountables. We need to use a container. For example, there is a glass of milk. Obviously, my friends, why there is one milk? Maybe in Spanish we say that, but in English, no, okay. In English, you need to say, like here, a glass of milk. However, it doesn't have it with countable. With countable, you can say, yes, there is only one hot dog, okay? But with the countables, you need a party, you need a container, you need to refer to a container. Look, no amounts. For example, how many donuts are there? Donuts is countable. You can say one donut, two donuts, three donuts, four donuts, okay? That's why we use how many, okay? How many donuts are there? There aren't any donuts. Here is the negative, okay? No more donuts, okay? For uncountable, how much, look, okay, how much bread is there? How much bread, remember, bread is uncountable in English. In Spanish, it's countable, but in English, the word bread is uncountable, okay? How much bread is there? There isn't any bread. Look, not any, and no, there are no donuts, there is no bread, okay? Any, very easy, my friends, is for negative sentence, okay? It doesn't matter if that is singular or plural, if that is countable or uncountable, okay? Some and any, look at the general rules, okay? For example, some is used when? With affirmative, there are some eggs in the fridge. And questions to offer, okay? For example, do you want some eggs? For offers, for requests, okay? Do you buy some eggs? For questions where the expected answer is yes. Three rules, okay? Number one, some is used for affirmative sentences, for offering questions, and for questions where you know that the answer is going to be yes, okay? Any. Number one is used for negative questions, sorry, for negative sentences and for questions. For example, there aren't any eggs in the fridge. Or, have you got any eggs? Four open questions. The answer can be yes or no. Very good, my friend. So thank you for watching this video. And remember, my friend, if you have questions, please ask me. Ask me the Benjamin or WhatsApp, and I will be answering your questions. Thank you very much.